The fear of the Lord,
the fear of the Lord
is the instruction of wisdom.
Now God never wants his children scared of him. The fear of the Lord means you reverence him. You have a reverence and a respect and an honor and a love for God. And when you have that, it's the instruction of wisdom.
Read. And before honor.
And before honor
is humility.
Before you ever get some honor, you got to humble yourself. This is what used to be happening in church. Guys are marrying a woman, and they come to me and say, Bishop, she don't honor me. She listen more to you than me. For two things I say. I say, hold up. First of all, do you listen to me? Because you read what you saw. If I can't instruct you, you probably won't be able to instruct her. See, because you get what you give out. Be not deceived, God is not mocked, for whatsoever man soweth, that's what you reap. And then I have to tell them, well, that comes with time. See, because they don't watch you. That's really, they don't really trust you yet. Oh, you think when you say I do, y'all trust each other, huh? The next day you're going to find out, we lived together for 10 years, you was on your way to hell. It didn't matter to the devil. Soon as you get married, that's what honor God. All hell, you're going to say, who is this I just married? But you wake up, her hands spinning around, bringing stuff to you out of heart. He looked like he just came from hell. It's a whole different person. Because now, the devil is mad. So he's gonna oppose that. He was loving when you was doing your own thing. Right? And so the woman gonna watch you. She tried to do the Bible, but you confusing her. So I tell the guys, I say, man, learn that word and stay consistent. You're gonna win her. But when you lie all the time and she catch you in 50 lies, she ain't gonna trust you.
Yeah.
Likewise, woman, he ain't gonna trust you. You said you're going to the store, you've been there for 10 hours because you stopped by mama and grandmama and... I'm trying to teach you integrity. Am I helping you?
Yes.
Let me tell you something. The quickest thing that will destroy marriage or any relationship is pride. Can't nobody tell you nothing. And when can't nobody tell you nothing, guess what? You can't tell nobody else nothing. Because you have the one that trusts or honor. Before honor comes, humility. Man, you trust them. They don't watch them. They consistent. Anybody ever hire employees? Okay, take this out. How do you start trusting your employees? You watch them. The best employees most of the time show up a half hour or more early. When they hit the clock, they hit the clock running. And what you don't know is, on the job, they have some of the spots where they're looking at you, you don't never know they're looking. And say, so they know if you're the real deal, because in the real deal, when they get in that spot, you're still working hard. But they know when you're not the real deal, because they walk out and then you see them. They already don't keep you. You don't know your evaluation time. Can you imagine the world? They gave me a penny promotion. They didn't want to give you that. They just didn't want you to go postal. 23 says, listen, what you do, do a quality, ask unto the Lord and not unto man. Because God is the one that's going to reward you. Don't do nothing in church and think I'm going to pay you. Church will help me. God is there every Sunday. Oh, you split Sunday because you want something from us? What did you do for the church? God shed his blood for the church. When he shed it for the world, you got to take advantage of it. Don't be doing nothing so somebody else can do something back to you. When you do a holiday act unto the Lord, you ain't looking for them to do nothing. You know it's coming from God. And can't nobody bless you like God. But that takes humility. That takes humbling yourself. Amen? So number two is honor. You want honor?